Dear friends, welcome back. This is Nick from educate.tv and today we're going to compare the computational speed of the Teensy board with the computational speed of the most popular Arduino boards. Without any further delay, let's get started. A few weeks ago, I published a video about the impressive Teensy 3.2 board. The specs of the board look fantastic. It uses a 32-bit ARM processor that can run at 96 MHz and has plenty of memory for our projects. From the specs, I thought that the performance of this tiny board would be similar with the performance of an Arduino Due, which is the fastest Arduino board available today. But is that right? Let's find out! Today's experiment is this: an Arduino Mega, an Arduino Due, and a Teensy 3.2 will run the same sketch, the Newton's approximation of Pi for half a million iterations. The time needed to execute this task is then displayed on a 1.8-inch color TFT display. This way, we're going to have a visual representation of the speed differences of the boards. In order to see how to connect the display with the Teensy or the Arduino boards, check out the tutorial I have prepared on that. First, I'm going to compare the Teensy with the Arduino Mega. The Arduino Mega uses an 8-bit processor which runs at 16 MHz. The Arduino Mega is having the same performance with the Arduino Uno, the Arduino Nano, and the Arduino Pro Mini. From the specs alone, we can tell that there is going to be a huge performance difference between the two boards. I have also connected a button to both boards, so when I press it, the computation of the PI starts on both boards at the same time. Let's start! As you can see, the Teensy board needed 3.5 seconds to perform this task. The Arduino Mega is struggling to calculate the PI and drive the display. The Arduino Mega needed 34.7 seconds to complete the same task. That's a huge difference. Teensy is almost 10 times faster than the Arduino Mega in this experiment. Let's now see the comparison of the Teensy board with the Arduino Due. Arduino Due also uses a 32-bit ARM processor which runs at 84 MHz. So, from the specs, the computational power of it should be similar to that of the Teensy. Let's try the same experiment. As you can see, the Teensy is faster than the Arduino Due as well. Arduino Due needed 7.1 seconds to complete the task, twice the time that Teensy needed. Teensy is so fast in this experiment. But this performance difference is bigger than I expected since both boards use similar processors. So I wanted to discover why there is such a big difference. In order to find out, I ran the same sketch, but this time I removed the TFT display just to compare the boards only at the calculation of the PI and not at driving the display as well. As you can see from the results, Teensy is still faster than the Arduino Due. It needed 2.7 seconds to run the algorithm for half a million iterations, while Arduino Due needed 3.3 seconds. In this experiment, without the TFT display, Teensy was about 20% faster. It seems that the library for the ST7735 TFT display is optimized for the Teensy board, that's why we had such a big difference before. The code of the project is based on the work of the user security, which posted his code on the Arduino forums. I slightly modified the code in order to use a button and to display the results on a color TFT display. If you wish, you can download the code of the project from a link which can be found in the description of the video. As you saw in this experiment, the Teensy board outperformed all the other Arduino boards. The speed difference with the 8-bit Arduinos is huge. Teensy was even faster than the Arduino Due, mostly due to better library support. But this is a single test and not a complete comparison of all the boards. Arduino Due is a very capable board and may be a better candidate for some projects than the Teensy board. This test was made just to see how fast Teensy is, and it is really fast. I think that the time to move our projects to 32-bit development boards has come. With the processing power that boards like the Teensy and Arduino Due offer, we can make more advanced projects easier than ever before. What do you think about that? Do you think that powerful boards like the Teensy or the Arduino Due can improve the projects you build. Please post your comments in the comments section below. If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects every Saturday. I love making things and I believe that anyone can make things. Anyone can become a maker. That's why I created this channel, in order to share my knowledge with the community and learn from the community. I hope you will join us. Until next Saturday, watch, learn, build.